Okay, so as an example of some of the new mesh relaxation routines I'm adding to the plugin, I'm going to show you how you can use it to achieve some quite nice sweeping curves of the structure, such as the London Great Museum court roof, which was a diagrid structure, a steel-framed supporting glass, and a mathematical surface was derived, which connected the outside square rectangular with the circular reading room in the middle of the court. So one of the plug-in routines allows you to first of all project a straight mesh up onto the mathematical surface, and then what we want to do is get rid of or make the sweeping lines much more continuous and flowing. At the moment you can see they crank and bend, it's just got the right connectivity. So we're going to use a technique called force density, which relaxes the vertices or the edges of the mesh to give it a much more curved and smooth approach. So I'm going to run it first of all just with balancing the force routine, and you can nominate a target surface that keeps the vertices projected up, vertically up onto that surface. I'm going to run it, if you can specify the number of loops that you wish to run it for to do this all in one go. I've broken it up into repeating routines of three loops, just to, so you can see the shape as it forms and takes place between each iteration. So what we end up with then is, you can see already it started to smooth out the appearance of the sweeping lines to give something much more akin to the effect achieved with the Great Court Roof. Then I went at once at the end just with balancing the edge lengths rather than the forces to give something quite similar appearance. And then what I can do is I can duplicate all the edges of the mesh using another routine from the plugin. Having applied the cross-section property to the layer, it generates and sweeps the rectangular profile across each curve that's just been added. I think the member size I've selected is a bit bigger than that used on the roof. You can try and slightly smaller surface and get that slightly lighter appearance and touch that they managed to achieve on the roof. And then just to show, you can very quickly then produce something quite nice and test. So we can now try rendering it with and without shadows, just to try and see what the finished appearance and shape of this effect might be. So have a try yourself, sometime shortly we'll be looking to add release dynamic relaxation, which will get an even better solution to this problem.